Hello, everybody. Okay, so yesterday I had a bit of an epiphany with a friend of mine. A very, what would you call her? What would I call her? Astute and intuitive friend. Anyway, we were talking about self-acceptance, and I realized that years ago I actually hated the word self-acceptance. The word. Oh, can you hear my washing machine? It's so noisy, but I'm so happy about it because it was broken. And anyway, yesterday I realized that to live effectively in the world, to live as your very, very most effective best self in the world, to be your most creative, really means to open yourself up, which is a kind of a vulnerability thing. And my washing machine is going off. It's like, yeah, I am washing these clothes so hard. And it's true, it does. It works very hard for me. So anyway, so I was thinking about that self-acceptance and what that means. And I don't know, it's a big journey, the journey of self-acceptance. Oh, it's like my washing machine just blew up. It'll be all right. Self-acceptance, oh God, what am I even saying? I don't even know what I'm saying. I'm so sorry. Self-acceptance, to accept the self, to lay it all bare, to be able to be your, not be your real self, but just to be without fear of what other people are thinking about you or how it might come across to other people. And it's the same as in art, making an artwork purely for the pleasure of making that artwork or for being the pleasure of, not just the pleasure, the exploration of self through that opportunity to converse with your world, your art materials and your hands-on experience with this world. So I'm rambling a bit, and all I really wanted to do was quickly get on and say that if you in your day can take even a small amount of time to ask yourself, stop and have a conversation or a dialogue with yourself about what it is that brings you pleasure, really brings you pleasure. Like, don't hold back with your conversation with yourself, because in getting to know yourself and in allowing yourself to speak, I know for me that it's been in allowing myself to admit the things that I want and the things that I don't want and the things that I like and the things that I don't like. It's been in that process that I've, you know, found the confidence and courage to be me, to get into the bath and speak to you at dawn. And it's what's opened up my creative process. So that's all. Self-acceptance is, we can have many conversations about that because there's so many aspects to it. But I was thinking yesterday that as we uncover these little core wounds within ourselves, that fear of being not accepted or ridiculed or something like that, it has all these little, it's like the core wound, and then it has these rays that radiate out, and on each of the end of these rays are like expectations that you have for the world or other people, to expectations of them to please you or to be a certain way. So as we get to know ourselves and accept ourselves, we dissolve the core wound, and with that all of these expectations for the world to be a certain way or people to be a certain way. So that brings freedom for us and freedom for the people around us. So that's really exciting, and freedom in our art and our creative process and in our work. Really, it's just breath, allowing ourselves to breathe easy. So the other thing quickly, I was just going to say, for people, a few people have been mentioning that they've been experiencing headaches and heart palpitations and things like that. Well, there is a lot of energy shifting on Earth at the moment, and that is bringing about heart opening. So if you're feeling that, don't fear. Just breathe through that, and be kind to yourself. And for headaches, I take double doses of magnesium, good magnesium, before bed, and I put Himalayan rock salts in the bath and a little bit of lavender or rose oil or something like that, and that seems to ease. Geranium is good. Okay, that's all.